When you're invited to join an existing team's workspace on Intercom, you'll get an email like this one, showing what team you're being invited to and some of the teammates who are already there. When you click to accept this invite, you can either sign up using a Google account or by entering your name, email, and a password, depending on how your company would prefer. So you might need to check with your manager on which version of these to take. Once you're signed up, you'll see a short form to tell us what you're using Intercom for and whether you've set up something similar in a previous role. This helps us personalize your experience both now and later on, so we know what kind of messages might be helpful for you and what not to bother you with too. You can also choose what you mostly use Intercom for. So here I'm going to pick to support customers, the department I'm in, I'll select customer support, and finally, the role I'm currently in. So for this course, I'm going to select support rep. To respond to customers, you'll need to have an inbox seat. So if you see this screen, make sure you ask your manager or an admin for your workspace to grant you an inbox seat so you can start resolving conversations for customers. And that's it. Now you have an Intercom account and you're ready to support your customers. But before we dive into the inbox, I'm just going to show you a little bit around the rest of a workspace. Over here in your workspace, we have the left nav, where you can see a bunch of Intercom products. Near the top, you'll find the inbox, where you're going to spend most of your time. Next up is automation. This is where you can configure how inbound customer conversations are handled. This is where you configure Finn, our AI bot, and can build automations that can assist in, or in many cases, fully resolve customer queries without requiring a team member's attention at all. Then we have our outbound or proactive support product. This is where you can send messages and campaigns directly to one or many customers or leads. Next is the contact area. Here's where you can view individual users or leads, see segments of them grouped together, or see the companies they may be collectively part of too. Next up, we have articles. This is where you or your team can create help docs for your customers. These can be read by the customers on your help center. They can be suggested by Finn automatically in the messenger, or they can also be suggested to you or your teammates in the inbox where you can send them on to customers too. Then we've got reports for your team or your manager to review and measure progress across all of the use cases in Intercom. But for here, that'll be primarily support. And then here towards the bottom, we've got another couple that I'll go through really quickly. This one lets you or a workspace admin change the setup of all your inbound and outbound channels, messenger, email, socials, SMS, and so on. And here we've got the App Store. This lets you or an admin install apps, which we'll get into in more detail later, but they can be used in the inbox, in the messenger, and in other areas of the Intercom product to help us integrate with the rest of your company's tech stack. And then we've got our What's New section, and this will let you see the latest updates to Intercom, which you or your team can take full advantage of. And last but not least, you've got your profile settings here. So here, if you've got access, you can change anything to do with your workspace, but mostly we're going to come in here right at the start and change our profile settings, like set our avatar, our status. You can update your workspace language. You can also see there's some helpful links for accessing the help center or adding posts to the community forum. So that's about it for here. Let's get into our workspace and setting up our profile.